APC serves the Imperium as its most commonly utilized troop transport. Entrusted to the Adeptus Astartes, Adepta Sororitas, and Inquisition, the Rhino has proven instrumental in the wars fought for his Imperium. Utilized throughout the Great Crusade, Horus Heresy, Scouring, and far into the 41st millennium, primarily deployed for use in newly explored, colonized worlds. Constructible from a vast array of materials, the Rhino would see a resurgence of development with the discovery of its long-lost standard template construct. Such a discovery burgeoning a vast variety of customized designs of the standard Rhino model, such as the Predator, Immolator, and Whirlwind. However, during the tumultuous age of strife, the STC systems would be lost. As such, the Rhino tanks would become symbols of the Imperium's might. Regarded as holy relics of war, the Rhino would accrue a reputation as the workhorse of the Imperium. A reputation that would only further grow with the rediscovery of the tank's STC. Resuming the construction of the Rhino, the illustrious vehicle would be deployed throughout the Imperium. No longer used solely by the Adeptus Astartes, the Rhino is once again widespread amongst the Imperium's armies. The Mark II Rhino would excel at transporting troops within the toughest of terrain and deadliest of battles, its large tracks carving a path through battle zones whilst protecting its passengers from harm. Armed with storm bolters for enemies in its immediate vicinity, the standard Rhino was also armed with secondary pintle-mounted storm bolters, hunter-killer missiles, and auto-launchers fitted with frag or blind grenades. Coated in dense layers of ceramite and plasteel, its hull is capable of deflecting even Astartes bolter rounds. Powered by the Mark II Mars Pattern Fermi combustor reactor engines, these van-assisted power sources connect two electric motors which power the engine. Also fitted with searchlights and smoke launchers, the Rhino can be upgraded with fittings of dozer blades and extra armor plating for tougher engagements. Its transportation capacity able to carry 10 Astartes within its chassis. Though unable to contain Terminator-clad First Company veterans of Space Marines fitted with jump packs. And whilst the Mark 1B Mars Pattern and Deimos Pattern still enduring the 41st millennium, their construction had been ended. Its successive variants and improved patterns forming the predominance of fielded units amongst the many campaigns amongst the stars. The Razorback being a relatively new construction is nonetheless one of the most prevalent patterns in use. Replacing its transport capacity to mount remotely controlled turrets on top of the vehicle, such as twin-linked heavy bolters or las cannons, the Razorback is less an APC and more a lightly armored assault vehicle. The Predator Rhino was adopted by the Adepta Sororitas as its primary battle tank. Equipped with turret-mounted autocannons or las cannons, and sponson-mounted heavy bolters on each side, the Predator also sacrifices transport capability to field more armaments and supplies. The Predator also sacrifices transport capacity to field more armaments and supplies. The Whirlwind Rhino provides long-range fire support for the Adeptus Astartes using its rack of Whirlwind missiles. So effective is its ability to suppress enemies that the Whirlwind has also borne variants of its own, the Hunter and Hyperios anti-aircraft vehicles. The Vindicator Rhino excels as a siege tank, armed with a demolisher cannon and large dozer blades known as siege shields. The shield protects the Rhino from enemy fire and clears debris from its path. The Damocles Command Rhino provides long-range communications to Astartes companies. Staffed by experienced communications officers, the Damocles can decrypt and intercept enemy communications, allowing for the tank's force commander to strategize and command forces accordingly. The Saber Tank Hunter is equipped with forward-firing laser destroyer or neutron laser cannons. Capable of destroying or at least immobilizing enemy vehicles, the Saber, whilst effective, proves difficult to produce its weapons. These shortages leading to the more widespread construction of its variant Vanquisher cannon loadout. The Immolator is used exclusively by the Ordo Militant and Adeptus Sororitas. Equipped with top-mounted twin-linked heavy flamer or multi-melters, combining transport capabilities with considerable firepower. The Exorcist is deployed exclusively by the Adeptus Sororitas. Providing long-range fire support, the Exorcist earns its namesake by replacing its troops' transport capabilities with an Exorcist missile launcher. The Incarcerator is utilized by the Ordo Hereticus, Adeptus Sororitas, and on rare occasions, Adeptus Arbites. Used to capture prisoners and high-value targets, the Incarcerator is fitted with an execution chamber, should justice need to be swift, In its judgment, the repressor rhino is fitted with firing slits to enable infantry inside a chassis to fire upon enemies outside whilst protecting the rhino's passengers. The Castellan rhino was created by the Iron Warriors Legion, primarily deployed during the Great Crusade. The Castellan bore unfolding plating and impact bracing to allow the vehicle to serve as a mobile bunker. Their modular construction allowing for chains of Castellans to interlock to create semi-permanent fortified lines and emplacements. And finally, the 41st millennium would see the birth of the Rhino Primaris. A variation on the Adeptus Astartes design, the Primaris Rhino would serve as command vehicles during the engagements of the Indomitus Crusade and beyond. In combination with Land Raider Excelsior tanks, the Primaris Rhino allows for officers to target orbital bombardment sites from fleets in orbit, whilst transporting squads of up to 6 Primaris Space Marines to the forefront of battle. For every battle waged by his Imperium, the Rhino serves as a bastion of protection, transportation, and fortification. For the Omnissiah's gifts are boundless, and each and every one is crucial for the continued survival of humanity.